Technology not only connects students and teachers, it plays a vital role in connecting students to the outside world. For example, in TinyARP,
there's about 900 and maybe 80 students in the whole district. Our economically disadvantaged population is about 54 to 56%. We have no radio station, no television, no museum, no library. We're just a small bedroom community, basically, for the Tyler-Longview area. Since we don't even really have a whole lot of business in our area, we don't have employment opportunities in the ARP area either. And so what we're trying to do is work with our students to give them skills where they will be ready for the future, for any future in any city where they go for employment.
So the first task for teachers is stimulating intellectual curiosity and a desire to learn that will take students wherever their interests lead them.
Our kids do not typically get a chance to go out and see museums or go out and see things that, you know, a kid in a big city might get to see. So, you know, we have to find ways to spark learning.
Technology has pushed our children to think outside the box and get out of this community and see that there's other things out there that they can do.
Floydada ISD, a small West Texas district more isolated than ARP, faced similar challenges.
Ideally, we would like our students to see past the city limit signs here in Floydada.
Some students are less fortunate, and so a lot of them have not been able to travel, I would say within maybe 100 miles from Floydada. And what the way it's impacted them is they would never talk about, well, I'd like to travel to a different country or so forth.
They had such very short limitations on themselves before they got out of high school, and they really didn't see their futures progressing very far.
And in doing these projects and allowing the world to come to them through technology, you know, after they've presented and they're talking and they're collaborating, I've heard, you know, several of my students emphasizing that they can't wait to travel to South America or Australia or these exotic places that they've researched on.
I was able to take that opportunity and benefit even more from it by being able to do something like, you know, study in Spain for a summer semester. And
technology closed another gap for Floydada students, the physical gap between them and the nearest college or university.
When you're 70 miles away from the closest community college, 85% low socioeconomic students, you know, that doesn't compute into kids continuing or going on to post-secondary education.
Having a laptop for every student made taking dual credit courses with faraway South Plains College practical and affordable.
So this is huge for our students to begin their college coursework at Floydada High School, where they have the support of their high school teachers to help make them successful. More than half of our seniors this year took at least one, and most of them took many more than one online course.
There's several people I can think of that wouldn't have gone to college without it, just because they do have the head start. And they've saved so much money doing it this way, it's way easier for them.
In El Paso, educators are also closing distances. In this case, through video conferencing.
We're so excited to see you, Dallas. How are you this morning? Everybody say hi, El Paso.
We were lucky enough to video conference with someone in our state, Cowart Elementary in Dallas, Texas. It looks to me that we're at the same level of socioeconomic impact and cultural impact as the school in Dallas.
We have 19 students in our class. How many do you have?
19.
Our class sizes were the same, which is really neat. And so this should be a perfect setup this year for students to have e-pals. I think the greatest thing that children can get is that not only are there other children out there in the world the same age, besides just their school and neighborhood, but that they're able to see different cultures, different cities.
Have any of you been to the state fair?
Nope. A few of you have.
We're able, as we're writing our letters to our pen pals, to do editing and publishing. We're able to send email electronically. So all of that can be involved through language arts.
I speak both English and Spanish. Con mucho gusto. It's nice to meet you. Do any of you speak Spanish?
Yes.
Wow, is that about half your class?
Looks like it.
That's pretty awesome that you guys.
I think the greatest thing that video conferencing brings to us is social etiquette. Children must learn to sit still because it distorts the picture. Children must learn to be quiet and allow others to speak. Common manners are reinforced during video conferencing. But what we tell the children is, you think about it, boys and girls, there's jobs all over the world. And if you want to go work in Africa or you want to go work in Europe, chances are for your first interview, it's going to be over a video conference.
We're going to get to show them things and they're going to get to ask us questions and everything.
You get to talk to new people.
We're going to be like friends.
We're going to write them letters and send them pictures.
I'd like to do a video conference every day.
Say goodbye, Dallas.
Goodbye, Dallas.
Have a good weekend, everybody.
The really important thing about the video conferencing equipment, and actually all of Web 2.0, is that it knocks down the walls. It just completely knocks down the walls of their campus. They're no longer limited to staying within that classroom. The video conferencing equipment, the Web 2.0 tools, allow students to jump way beyond our geographical area.
Video conferencing is also used to great advantage within the district, extending a single teacher's reach to several classrooms.
We created a network within our district of video conferencing, another virtual school where students in a school that may not have access to a particular course could, through video conferencing, take that course with another one of our campuses.
Now we're really breaking the mold, and we're finding ways that we can use technology to really overcome teacher shortages in these advanced areas.
AP teachers are very hard to get, especially AP teachers in very niche little areas. AP art teachers are very difficult to find. AP music teachers are very difficult to find. So if you find one and you're able to share that teacher on multiple campuses, that's what that technology allows us to do. Those students that wouldn't be able to take those courses, all of a sudden, through the use of video conferencing technology, have access to that teacher, have access to the course. It enriches their entire high school or learning experience.
How many of you think you have it already? Okay, cool, good. Let's give you one more shot at it though. If you think you have it, check your work.
What we're seeing is that the enrollment in dual credit classes is exploding in our district. A few years ago, it was just a few hundred students, and now there's thousands of students in our high schools that are actually enrolled in dual credit classes. And so that tells us that we're putting the idea of college into the minds of kids that wouldn't normally have those ideas.